What's up, guys and gals? Welcome back to the Nerdcastle for the next episode of this War of Mine. So we had a pretty good run last night. Now, a number of people... Well, no, not a number of people, just Bruno. Bruno had gotten himself injured over the course of the day. So let's go ahead and we'll put everybody to bed that we need right now. I'm going to keep Anton up. She is hungry, slightly wounded, and tired. Okay, food supply is still looking reasonably decent. It's not looking amazing, but I think it's manageable at the moment. But the nice thing is, we brought home like 4 guns last night. And so what I'm thinking about doing is we'll trade off the shotgun for more components tonight. We'll bring that back. We'll use the components to fix the other guns. Once we fixed all the other guns, we'll barter those into even more things that we can use. You'll forgive me. This is my first video of the day that I'm recording, and so I'm getting all stammer-voiced and whatnot. It happens from time to time. It's like a warm-up thing. I have like a little warm-up routine I do, but I didn't do it this morning because I was too excited about playing this War of Mine. Now, someone had mentioned that Anton does very, very well at setting traps, and that's actually what good mathematician helps out with. That's an interesting thing, and I would love to see if that's the case. And so I guess from now on, I guess there's really no harm in allowing him to set all the traps. Let me take a look at how many things we have at the moment. So we're completely and totally out of componentry. That has been the story of our life throughout the course of the entire game here. We've got enough guns to last everybody. We still got a lot of bullets. We had a raid last night that we had to deal with, so that's okay. I mean, it's not Excelsior, but it's definitely not awful either. We've got enough food to last a couple days. I think we could actually make a couple things work here if we wanted to. We're also out of fuel. No, we have 6 fuel. We have 6 fuel. Go light the fire, man. Go on, Anton, light that fire. You can go over here. I give you permission. Go ahead. I haven't sang you a song about it. It's day 41. They said UN peacekeepers should be around shortly in order to fix our problems, or at least to cause some kind of ceasefire or something. Whether or not that's going to happen soon, I don't know. I'm hoping it happens soon because survival gets very, very nasty on the back end of this game. It becomes very, very difficult to consistently ensure that you can get the things that you want. And in fact, after a certain point in the game, it seems like certain aspects of the game, certain construction materials just vanish altogether after certain points. And so at day 41, the city is more or less picked clean, and all you can really do is trade for the things that you want. I'm not going to trade with Franco anymore because he's simply just gotten way, way, way too greedy. And unfortunately, there's no way to get a good deal out of him. The only thing that I would consider trading for is just componentry from him. But even then, you're getting kind of a bad deal. We don't have... Do we have any filters right now? I guess I can go check. Find out real fast. These guys should all be up, and ladies, should all be up by... I was trying to distinguish that because I've heard it's like a regional thing, actually. We had a discussion a long time ago where people had kind of just like been arguing in the comments section about... Because what I used to do is in the beginning, I'd be like, what's up, guys? And because regionally, that's, you know, where I live, that's how you address like a mixed group of people. Nobody sees anything wrong with it. Like, if a girl walks up to a group with a whole bunch of guys and girls mixed, they'll be like, oh, hey, what's up, guys? And things like that. But apparently that didn't translate very well, like, regionally to, like, different countries where you've got, I guess, like, section... I wouldn't call... What is it called? It's got a linguistic word. But anyways, certain languages distinguish different aspects or different people, nouns, etc. by sex. And so it doesn't translate very well into those regions. So I just started saying guys and gals just to distinguish the whole thing. They're like, yeah, whatever, it's fine. It works. We picked our house clean. Sometimes I find myself wishing I could chop down these doors and make wood out of them or something. But what we might be able to consider is if we go back to the place that we went. We have 1 Band-Aid left. Okay. I just wanted to make sure. What do these guys have? Bruno could have gotten killed by that thug. I'm glad he managed to come back. Oh, good. Alright, so everybody apparently knows that he got into a fight. I got one of those scumbags, but I could still hear my heart pounding. Yeah, I'd bet. Nothing like the thrill of close combat to get you all nice and riled up. That's an adrenaline rush right there. If I remember my fisticuffs days from the 8th grade, definitely get your blood going. Get your blood going real, real quick. I think the temperature should be fine if we just ride out our fuel right now. What I'm hoping we can do is I'm going to take the hatchet back with me to the same place we went before. Bare minimum... I'm going to try and chop up everything in that house because there's only 1 thug left, and I think I can get rid of him fairly easily. We just got to figure out a way to bait him around, and if we can get that to work, we can take him out, we can take his weapon, we can loot the rest of the house, although I think it's probably about 75% looted at this point. But the bonus right there is that we can break down all the furniture and bring back as much as wood as possible. Wow, that was a voice crack. Definitely going to be one of those days, huh? It's going to be one of those days, isn't it, universe? It's going to be one of those days. All right, I see how it is. I see how it is, and... Okay, so how come nobody's getting out of bed here? Eh? It might be too late to cook a meal. I was going to cook a meal, but I think that he's not going to be able to get like 4 or 5 meals done by the time all of this goes live. I'm not sure what to think about Bruno's deed. The guy was a bandit, but was killing him necessary? Hell yeah, especially when there's reprisals to worry about. You never know when you're going to come across that guy in the town square, and then he's going to be on again. He's going to be all recovered, and you're not going to have the advantage anymore. When it comes to combat, there's winners, and there's body bags, and there's nothing in between. There's no rules in combat. There are no rules whatsoever. So unfortunately, you got to do this kind of medieval style and make sure your enemies are gone for good so that they can't cause you future problems. If you know what I mean. And so tonight, I'm actually a little bit torn as to whether I want to scavenge or whether I want to go... I think we've got enough fuel to make things work, but we've got to make meals. I don't know if I want to trade tonight or if I want to scavenge. I think I might scavenge. Was it the small apartment building that we hit up? Lots of meds, huge amounts of weapons, but no parts left. That's fine, actually. I don't really care about that. So I guess I'll put everybody on guard duty. And we've got our scavenging going. I don't think we're going to get hit again tonight. It seems unlikely. But let's take Bruno. I'm going to have him bring an axe. And I'm going to have him bring a crowbar. And anything else that we need to get out of the place. I think I already... I can't remember now. I recorded that 2 days ago. I can't remember if I got... If there was bars there that we couldn't get through. If we already handled bars. I think we already handled bars. So I think I'm just going to go with these two things right here. If there's another guy set up over here, we're going to try and take him out to the best of our ability. But I would like to break down a lot of the furniture here. Just to see if I can get things working. Now this guy's a little bit problematic. If he turns to the right, we're good. But if he comes back this way, or if he stays right where he is... Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to go inside. Occasionally he gets bugged. And he just like sits around and does nothing. It's happened to me in previous plays where he'll just like stand right here the entire time, or he'll come over here, but you can tell he's not acting naturally because he's got like this twitchy thing going on. So I think we got everybody, so I'm not gonna worry too much about being quiet and not making a ruckus. I don't know where their restroom is either, the room which they rest. I guess the restroom is not what I'm looking for here, but that's what I mean right there, is breaking down some of this furniture is going to benefit us in the long term if I can make it happen. Is this guy... I don't know if he's in there or where he's at. Okay, so yeah, he's in there. There's no hiding spot anywhere else, so we may not actually have to kill him. I may be able to just sneak around and stay out of his line of sight and we'll be okay. A couple more tradable items, that's fine. Acceptable. Something's blocking from the other side. I'm gonna do my best not to leave doors open. Seems like kind of a bad plan right now. What we could attempt to do, actually... is... Ooh, it might be risky. Might be risky. So I'm trying to think of a plot to bait him up here. Did he hear that? Doesn't actually sound like he did. So let's break down this furniture so at the bare minimum we bring back some wood tonight. And if we hear him say anything about noise, we'll just deal with that then. And I'll try and sprint over and hide here. Or at least run off somewhere else. He also might see this door right here. Sometimes their line of sight sees things that... Alright, so we'll chop that down. I don't know how to get into that room right now, but we'll just keep an eye on it throughout the day. And if he leaves, we'll try and sneak back in there and get whatever we can out of it. For right now, we really, really, really need as much wood as we can carry. And then I would love to find those meds, too. That would be the second part of the equation here that I guess I wouldn't be... too worried about. I'm sorry, that I would be worried about is that I... Is there anybody up there? Or is that just rats? I think it was just rats last time I went up here, but let's go look just in case. Rather be safe than sorry. Okay, so it looks like we got a room that's blocked off. Oh yeah, it was the flapping shutter. I forgot about that. Alright, well let's go through everything. Whatever we can find is helpful. So we got weapon componentry. We got that. We'll come back for those, I guess. It says there's a huge amount of weapons here. I'm gonna sneak around a bit though. And see if maybe we can't figure out what to do with some of this. Now over here... Oh, there is another thing that you could bring a saw for. Is it rats that he's looking at? I'm a little bit concerned about this guy right here. I could break this open, but... It's definitely going to make some noise, and if he has a firearm, then it's not going to be good for us. I would prefer that he go somewhere else, actually. Come on. I can bring a lockpick back next time. It's not that big of a deal. But a third trip is not really... No, don't go that way. Don't do that. It also said there's something over here, so we might be able to get by moving some rubble around or something. It looks like I missed a bunch of stuff over here, or at least I wasn't able to access some of the stuff over here. Oh no, that's a loot pile. Okay, so let's have a look at the loot pile then. Just more bullets. I've noticed that these big scrap piles, they used to have a lot of useful stuff in them, and now they're just kind of like there. They don't really do anything for you anymore. They have like a couple bullets in them at the best. A little bit of tobacco right there. I don't mind the trade fodder. Oh yeah, there's a way to get around right there. That's kind of cool. Okay. Let's sneak back downstairs. He's still just hanging out in there, huh? Alright, well, if there's no way to bait him out of there, we'll have to fight him. So maybe come back with a shotgun on the next night. Does he have a gun or anything? Let's look and find out. What kind of firearm is he packing? I don't actually think he has a firearm. He might be beatable. We'll figure it out next time. We'll come back over here in a little bit. I found a to-do list. It must be a group with some crude regime. The point is interesting. Who's leaving booze behind the shitter? Clean up the mess. Oh, really? There's booze behind the toilet? Oh, he's coming. We got our stuff. It's okay. And now we know there's booze behind the toilet, too, unless we already looted that, but we'll go look after this. We gotta have enough trade fodder to make it worth it for us to run all the way out there and get that stuff. Wasting an entire night trading is kind of like one of those hand-wiggling exercises, and maybe it's better to go out and scavenge, maybe it's not better to go out and scavenge. It's a tough call. Alright, so he made it back. Hopefully we didn't get raided again, because that would be all troublesome. Okay, Sveta has a deep wound she could do with some bandages. Yeah. Alright, well, we'll try and make that work, I guess. Let's go ahead and get everybody... I guess I'll use my last bandage on her since I don't have a choice. I don't like the way your wounds just randomly get worse after a couple of days. I've never actually seen that happen, and I've had a fairly deep gash that I didn't stitch. I mean, I had a really, really deep gash that bled for like days. It was pretty bad. And I just duct taped it shut with some gauze inside of it and switched it every day. And that seemed to do the trick perfectly fine. But I guess they're supposing that we don't even have like the bare basics, so I guess I won't complain too much about it. She's now very hungry, which means we need to make sure tonight that we're getting back out here and we're cooking meals for everybody. I should have cooked it yesterday. Okay. I lost track of things because I hadn't played in a little bit, but it'll be okay. We can make it work. She's wounded, bandaged, and tired. I think we will have to go on a trade run. Well, I think we have enough fodder to maybe make it worth it. We'll have to see what's going on over here. Let's check the radio. So, classical music. Upcoming days will be cool. That's it, though. There's still word of peacekeepers coming around and trying to help, but whether or not that's going to actually happen or not. Okay, and so we have confirmation that indeed the peacekeeping forces are en route to Pegoran. Alright, well, we just gotta hang out. I think we can make it. We did a pretty good job of surviving, all things considered. If you remember, this is my first playthrough of the game. I know a lot of people that I've watched play that didn't make it, like they ended up dying around day 25, day 27, and so forth. I think a lot of the survival, for example, we wouldn't have survived the winter if I hadn't known about the axe, which was directly through the comments, so that's a bonus, and I think definitely reading the comments and adapting to what was coming on one or two occasions saved our lives. I'm disappointed that both Pavel and Marco didn't make it out, considering how useful they were to the overall effort. I might trade for componentry with this guy, but that's about it. And that's only to get enough componentry to where I can fix the guns and make them work a little bit better here. Hustle a tad. That's as fast as you can go. Well, damn. Alright, these guys aren't going to get up out of bed, so I got to keep an eye on them. Everybody's hungry and wounded and whatnot, so... If I can get enough componentry off him to make it worth it. It depends how many... Oh, it won't do try harder. I didn't see a swap over. I don't know why I didn't see that. My eye didn't notice the movement when it said it's no longer a deal. So we can get 22 out of the shotgun. Let me see what else I could trade for it first. So we'll go tobacco. We'll go the slight sick thing. And maybe go with a... Frankly, I could just drop a whole bunch of sugar too. It doesn't even matter. We have pure alcohol too. I don't want to get rid of my water. He can't have my water, but... Basically, I'm just trying to get out of the back end of this thing without... Okay, so there it is. As many components as I can get so that tonight... I can then go here. Well, you get out of here. Now that I've got componentry, all I need to do is fix all the guns at this point. And if I fix all the guns, I can basically be an ironmonger. I can take those back up to the square and trade those out for as many things as I possibly can. I'm going to get her position down here... So that once everybody's rested, they can get going. Let me go on up there with him. And we'll see if we can fix that. He is very hungry, so let's get him up. And over here, we will have him make us a meal. Maybe a couple of meals. Yeah. There we go. We'll get those loaded up. No. All right, I need you right there. And what I need you to do... Oh, it actually doesn't take componentry. Alright, well that was a little bit of a waste, but not that much of a waste, so I don't really care that much. Can I build both of them? Oh, I can. Fantastic. Build both. Build both Baggins. He was kind of like, he was the member of the Baggins family who was really, really good at simultaneous ambidextrous building. If you were playing a real life RTS, you would definitely want him on your team. His actions per second are ridiculous. Just absolutely insane. If I can get him to fix these guns, though, we can go tonight, and we can trade for just about everything that we need. I don't need weapon parts for that, right? No, I don't, actually. Okay, so fix the gun, too, and then we'll make the bullet vest tonight, so that that'll be ready. Everybody start eating, I guess. That probably won't get us back to where we need to be. But it'll get us far enough, I think. Brings Feta back that. He's gonna feed her. Okay, so that's good. I like how you can hand things off in between characters too. That's actually a really cool feature. We found a helmet somewhere. Oh no, it was for trade. That's what it was. The helmet was for trade. We've got more than enough componentry to make some more bullets, but I'm gonna make the bullet vest first to increase our survivability. Maybe have Anton eat another meal. I'm just trying to get as many people fixed up on food as possible. Tonight we're gonna trade for food. We're gonna trade for components. We're gonna trade for everything we can. This evening, just to see if we can make ourselves a tad more survivable for a few more days. That's all that matters right now, is we just need to be more survivable for a few more days. Over here with the fuel, absolutely make us some more if you can. We'll try and keep the house warm. With him right there, we've got enough to where we can make a couple more bullets, and so I think that's probably an amazing idea, considering we are still getting hit by raiders. Making sure that we have a lot of the things that we need is going to bring this puppy home. And everybody knows that you want to bring puppies home. Who doesn't love bringing puppies home? I mean, come on. They're puppies, huh? We're also going to need to trade for some water tonight, if I can make it work. Very hungry. He's good. So I need basically four more meals. How long will that take? Can I get that done before the end of the day? It'll take 1 hour. It'll be close, but... What I need to do then is I need to get him down here close so that he can eat a couple right before the day ends. I don't know if everybody's going to get fed right here, but if they don't, we will feed them on the morrow. Alright, so you eat. The food will still be there tomorrow, so it's not that big of a deal, but it does need to get done. You eat. Hopefully it doesn't take you like 45 minutes to eat like it does me. I am the slowest eater on earth in real life. People actually get physically irritated with me. Not physically irritated, but people get like really, really miffed because I take so long to eat. But I like to savor things. That's just how I am. I've always been a person who loves food. Hey, you've survived. I don't even need to trade. That's it? It's just like, it's over? I wanted to trade my guns. Wow, what a game. Our neighbor felt unsafe and asked us to help her board up her windows, and we did that. Day 7, the girl in peril. Marco didn't save a poor girl from a drunken soldier. So this is when it's going to go through and remind you of all the decisions you had to make. Desperate cry for protection. We agreed to help her. Well, there's some huge horse pills right there. Helping each other. We helped a man get medication for his father. Marco died on day 22. Shouldn't point your gun at your foot like that. That shit's gonna hurt when it goes off. Pull the trigger on X, and then again, I didn't look and see if his hand was on the trigger. Indecent proposal. One of our neighbors asked us to help him rob a rich family, and we refused. Pavel murdered several people. See, that's weird, but the game didn't, like, bring that out. It's very, very strange. He was, like, barely even sad about it, as I recall, but it's probably fine. A sniper's victim. A neighbor's brother got wounded by a sniper bullet. Anton helped carry him to safety. Pavel was killed while looking for supplies. That was when we gave up our medication. I remember that. For the kid's mother or whatever, we gave up like everything we had for it, actually. We had basically nothing left. Hungry children, but we didn't have anything for them. I recall that as well. I would have given them the raw food. We had plenty of food left over. Day 42. The ceasefire. The long-awaited ceasefire finally came into force, eventually putting an end to the fighting at Pogorin. Those who managed to survive the war in Grasnovia would never forget it. Indeed, this would be the situation of a lifetime for you. Surviving the war, Marin set about finding the boy who once brightened his day. His efforts proved futile, so he rebuilt his house and kept the action figure in the shop window. One winter afternoon, the entrance bell rang, and a familiar smile has once again filled Marin's workshop and his life with light. The war didn't extinguish the flame that drove Veda to give everything to her calling, and one day she got a visit from a formal pupil, the same who made a frantic call one Friday to make sure that his old school had really been evacuated. While war left deep marks on Anton's character, he returned to teaching with newfound determination, and while too old for the Fields Medal, he is still eligible for the equally prestigious Abel Prize. After the ceasefire, Bruno went looking for his friend. Her neighborhood saw heavy fighting and most of the houses had been reduced to ruins, but she found shelter in a basement which held. Eating rats and scavenged scraps of food, she somehow managed to survive. Bruno felt responsible for her misery. He's never forgiven himself. For all his efforts, Marco was rewarded with a shallow grave. Maybe his wife and daughters would find it someday, on condition that they managed to survive the persecutions themselves. Sadly, Pavel died as well. Will his family come back to Pogorin to visit his grave one day? Or would it be too painful, a reminder of what they had gone through? Did the dead even care? And I guess that's it. My name is Splattercat. Thank you for joining me here for This War of Mine, which was a fun series. I like this game a lot. The only thing I didn't like was the combat system. I really wish the combat system was a little bit more... The stealth system works fine, so don't get me wrong right there. But I mean, like, when you're actually in melee combat, it's a little bit weird... landing your hits. It feels like if you click wrong, they just get to hit you like 30 times straight, but if you click right, you get to hit them a bunch of times and kill them. That's the only thing about this game that I didn't enjoy, but by and large, everything else was fantastic. So I'd like to thank the developers for allowing me to put this up on YouTube. Without developers allowing us to make these videos, I would not have a job. This would not happen. None of us would, well, I guess we could still make videos based on certain technicalities, but still, it's very, very nice of developers to allow us to do this. I will see you all in the next game that we decide to play. Take care, everybody, and hi-do!